Welcome to the video lecture of Identifying Object Relationship Attributes and Methods. In the last video lecture, we discussed about the association and inheritance relationship. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss about the part of relationship and a case study which covers all the association and inheritance part of relationship. So part of relationship is known as aggregation. A part of relationship also called aggregation, which represents the situation where classes consist of several component classes. The classes are having other classes. This does not mean that classes behave like its parts. For example, a car consists of many other classes. One of them is a radio. But car does not behave like a radio. Two major properties of part of relationship are transitivity, second is anti-symmetry. First one, transitivity. It says A is a part of B, B is a part of C, then A is a part of C. A is a part of B, B is a part of C, then A is a part of C. For example, take a example, a carburetor is a part of an engine, engine is a part of a car, therefore a carburetor is a part of a car. Anti-symmetry, A is a part of B, then B is not a part of A. For example, engine is a part of a car, but car is not part of an engine. Where the responsibility for clear behavior must reside. Before identifying where the responsibility for the certain behavior must reside. Clear distancing between the part and whole is achieved with the help of the following questions. Does the part class belong to a problem domain? Not ask these questions. Is a part class system responsibility? Does a part class capture more than one single value? If it capture only a single value, then simply include it as an attribute with the whole class. Does it prove an useful abstraction in dealing with the problem domain? So these questions should be asked to identify the part, whole and part relationship. The part of relationship patterns. The first pattern is assembly. The whole is constructed from its part. Assembly part situation physically exists. For example, a French soup consisting of onion, butter, flour, wine, French bread, and cheddar cheese. Second is container. A physical whole encompasses, but it is not constructed from the physical part. It is a container only. Whole is a container. Whole contain parts, but whole is not made up of parts. This is a container relationship. A case such as a course teacher situation, where a course is considered as a container. Teacher is assigned to a specific course, but the course is not constructed by using teachers. So house is a container relationship again. House container is a furniture and appliances are part of the house, but house is not constructed using the furniture and appliances. Third one is collection member relationship. A conceptual whole encompasses a part that may be a physical or conceptual. For example, a soccer team is a collection of players, a football team which contains a collection of players. Next, case study. We are going to discuss with the using of case study. This is Binet ATM bank system case study. So by using this case study, we are entering the classes, how we are forming the association and inheritance relationship, and as well as the whole part relationship are discussed in this case study. So several relationships exist in the Binet ATM bank system. First one is develop a UML use class diagram based on use case analysis. One class diagram for a system show the identity and definition of the classes and their interrelationship and various packages contained in a group of classes. Multiple class diagram represents various pieces or views of the system class diagram. Multiple class diagram that shows the specific static relationship between the various classes. So these are the classes identified for the Binet ATM bank system: bank, bank line, ATM machine, transaction account, saving account, and checking account. These are the classes are identified by analyzing the use cases of the Binet ATM bank system. So here, we are defining the association. Each bank client has an account. Every bank client has an account. Okay, a bank client can have one or two accounts. So this is has a relationship. So during the definition, the bank client association is a multiplicity. One client can have one or more account. So similar other associations are given: account and bank client. Okay, bank client has an account. Okay, one bank client has one account. Bank client account relationship. A bank client can have one or two bank account. Saving account, checking account is a relationship. One saving account should have a checking account. The checking and saving relationship is the checking account should have a zero or more saving account.
account transaction relationship. Okay, an account has zero or more transaction. Transaction and account. One transaction should contain one account. So these are the other association. This is represented here. Okay, bank client has have one or two accounts. Account can have a minimum one transaction. A transaction belongs to more than one account. One checking account should have a one saving account. So association among the Vinet ATM system class are shown here. These are the association. Identify the aggregation or part of relationship. A bank consists of ATM machine, accounts, building, employees, and so forth. Since building and employee are outside the domain of the application, we define the bank class as a aggregation with the ATM machine and account class. So for example, if you have a bank class, so bank class, take a bank class as an aggregation with the ATM machine account class. So bank, a bank class account is a part of a bank and ATM machine is a part of bank. This is known as a aggregation. So association. So next is we can say that association, generalization, aggregation among the various ATM bank classes are shown here. Notice that super sub arrow for the checking account, saving account. Checking account and saving account. Okay, these classes are what to say. These classes are known as they are the super class subclass relationship with the account class. They are both are merged. The relationship between the bank client and the ATM machine is shown with the interface. Okay, a bank client can access the ATM machine with the help of the interface. Okay, the solid line with the circle is shown as interface. So bank client can access the ATM machine, okay, with the help of this interface. So this is the way we finalize the various classes, then identify the association and whole part relationship and the super class subclass relationship. The checking account and saving account are the subclass of the account relationship. So everything is properly, all the three relationships are properly defined by using the use case. Okay, thanks for watching the video. Thank you.